it's really not about fixing that backdrop problem. It's just how we're going to hide it. What's going on, creative family? It's Dustin Valkema. Guys, it feels so good to be back. You could probably see the bags under my eyes. I've had my head down grinding. And I want to show you guys something that hopefully will help out a lot. I've gotten a lot of questions on it recently, as a lot of these cosplayers from the Comic-Con that I was discussing in my community posts had started posting their images, and everybody is like, dude, how did you go through and edit 250 of these photos in a week and make the backdrop so smooth and seamless and everything just look good? So today I'm going to show you guys how I did that, and then I will also show you how I put this in an action so that I could rapid fire through all of the photos and just reduce the amount of time and clicks that I spent on each individual photo. So make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I will see you guys in Photoshop. All right, guys, here we are in Photoshop taking a look at this awesome photo of Rhino cosplay. Now, we can see here the distractions that are going on in the background. This really isn't too much of a problem here with a gaff tape on the floor, but we really want to get this cleaned up so that we can provide a really nice, seamless look to our client. And so in this case, just judging, I really don't like to use the pen tool. It takes a little bit long for most of the work that I do. So what we can do is we can try a couple different ways. I'll leave a link to the tutorial that I have on selecting your subjects easily, so that you guys can, get a little bit more in depth with this if you'd like to. But what we'll do here is press Control or Command J to duplicate the background. What I think we can try is select subject. So let's go ahead and press select subject here. So to get to that, you just press W for the wand tool, and then you'll see the select subject button there up top. And at this point, we can just zoom in here, and I can see that it's already not really giving me too much of the result that I want. You can see that there's quite a clear contrast between the subject and the background in a lot of these areas, and it's still cutting into the subject more than I'd like. So what I'll do in this case is just press Control or Command D to deselect that. And then using my wand tool, I'm using a tolerance of 15 right now, but I'll just go through, and this will allow us to do a really rough cutout of our subject. So we can start the cleaning process. All right, so here what we can do is press Q, which is going to bring up our quick mask. Now, in a previous tutorial on cutting your subjects out, I talked about using this similar to a layer mask. So anything that is clear, or say white and not red on the background, is going to be selected, and everything that is red will be cut out from that selection. Now at this point, we've got everything set up for us, and so we can press Q to exit our quick mask mode, Control or Command Shift I to invert that selection, and then we can just press Control or Command J that will duplicate that layer, or duplicate our cutout here. And so now we can just name these layers. We'll name this one here on the bottom clean. The one on the top, we'll name it sub for subject. Well, at this point, I've already got Spider-Man cut out, and you need to get rid of everything that's distracting us in this photo. So on the clean layer, I'll just go ahead and grab my spot healing brush, and I can go through and remove this gaff tape here on the floor. I think there's a piece of hair there. I usually don't worry too much about it, especially for what I'm doing here, because we will be putting a grunge texture over it anyways. But just some of these smaller elements and things that will stick out like a sore thumb. So at this point, I'll call that clean, and I'm quite happy with that. So what we can do is just grab a brush tool with our pen pressure sensitivity off and 100% opacity, and we'll use an off-round brush and just use Alter Option and click and select one of the darker colors here on the background. And we can just go ahead and paint and just remove everything from the outside of Spider-Man there. We can do the same thing here on the other side and go ahead and just paint that right out. And now for all of the wrinkles and, you know, the little bits of warping that's going on here, we'll just grab the lighter color with a little bit bigger brush. We can just go ahead and paint that right out. So at this point, we've got a pretty nice and seamless transition. So this is ideally what I'm looking for in any case. Now here we can see that we have a little bit left on the outside of Spider-Man there. Normally, I wouldn't worry about that too much, but just for the sake of how to clean it up, I'll just grab a layer mask and then a black brush. Make my brush size quite a bit smaller there. And then I'll just take my brush and I'll go right on the outside of this guy here. So that layer mask will deal with that quite nicely. Now that we have our subject cut out and the backdrop clean, what I really like to do in most of my work is add some kind of texture detail there to the backdrop. Sometimes I use noise. In this case, I'm using a hand-painted backdrop texture from the Retouching Toolkit's add-on, which is great. But we can just go ahead and place your grunge texture, your backdrop texture, whatever kind of texture you want to use, and set that on mode to soft light. I do not want this texture to affect Spider-Man here, especially in the eyes it gets weird. I actually wouldn't mind it too much on the rest of the suit. But if you're dealing with skin tones, you clearly want to get rid of this. And so I just press Ctrl or Command and click the thumbnail of my subject layer there. So that will just create that selection, and we can press Alt or Option now and click our layer mask button. And that will create an inverted layer mask so that our backdrop texture is only affecting our backdrop. Now at this point, the last thing that I would do here, especially for these client deliveries, I wasn't too concerned with matching the perspective of the backdrop as it went from the foreground to the background. I was more concerned with just creating a nice clean result that my clients would enjoy while keeping my time to a minimum per image. And so what I did here is I just ended up using the blur gallery. So if you head up to filter, blur gallery, and I went to tilt shift. Now tilt shift is nice because you have these nice linear blurs that happen here. And so if I grab this control and I bring that line down, I can grab my main anchor. I can bring that down to where essentially the back line is just hitting the foot. And I can rotate this slightly because the camera was tilted. Now, if you've never dealt with the blur gallery or the tilt shift here before, basically everything that's inside of these two solid lines, there is no blur that's affecting your image. And then from the solid line to the dotted line here, that's just the transition state. And then anything past it, past this dotted line, is 100% affected by the blur amount that you have here in this wheel. And so we'll go ahead and we can just bump that blur up a little bit there. What I'm looking for is a little bit more of like a smooth and milky blur behind my subject, and then transitioning down into the backdrop or the floor here, just to give it kind of a nice and cleaner look. All right, guys, now that's it here for this tutorial. You can see that we went from point A, which was quite cluttered and distracting, to a nice clean result and something that our clients would really enjoy to have their hands on. All right, guys, so that process there for the first part of the tutorial was going about it a little bit slower to explain more in depth how I did this. Now, in my actual scenario, I didn't really have a whole lot of time to spend working, and I averaged about anywhere from 8 to 10 minutes per image from this process to post-production in Lightroom. And so what we'll do is we'll create an action real quick that will show you exactly how I ran that process. So what we'll do here is head up into our actions panel and create a new action. And we can just name that BG Fix. Click record. We can press Ctrl or Command J to duplicate our background layer. We can name that clean. And then we can press Ctrl or Command J again to duplicate that layer. And we can name that sub. Now what we'll do here is press W for our wand tool. press select subject. And that is going to create a rough selection of our subject here. And we can go ahead and just press our layer mask icon here down in the layers panel to create a layer mask for that. Now, once that's finished, I need to tell Photoshop to grab my background texture and throw that in so that I have that on top of everything else. So we can go ahead here and go to File, and we'll say Place Embedded. I'll move this off here so I can search these, and I will grab my background texture and select Place. Now with this here and the actual action I did, most of them were actually portrait shots, and so I had that oriented properly. But in this case, we can just go ahead and rotate that 90 degrees, and we can go ahead and fill our document with that and press Enter. Now we can head up and set this to a soft light blend mode. We can go ahead here to our subjects layer and select the layer mask, Control or Command click that layer mask icon, select our background, and then we can go ahead and press Alt or Option and create a layer mask there. So now we're ending up with our background selection there. And now in this case, what we'll do is head right down to the clean layer, and then we can stop our action. And now what this did is this set everything up for me so that I really wouldn't have to worry about too much of placing things and knowing where everything was at. And my layer masks are already set in a pretty decent fashion. And now with that texture off, I can just grab my brush tool, go ahead here and select the background color, and I can do a rough paint in. I can do the same thing here, select on that side. And that did a pretty good job there. And we can move right over to the other side and clean that up as well. Select the mid-tone color there again. And now at this point, I can just go ahead and press J to get rid of some of these quick little distractions that are happening here. That one was a little bit off. But now we can just turn on our other layers. And we have a pretty nice clean result. And then I already have my action button here for the tilt shift. This was really depending on the particular image with how I used it, so I did not include that in the action, but I can go ahead and grab my tilt shift, move that guy down into place, not create another one, move that down into place, and then rotate it. I can up my blur and press Enter. So that's it, guys. That's how you go through this process pretty quickly and creating the action there. We can go ahead and run this real quick so that we can see exactly how the action runs. So at this point now, with my background selected, or my background layer, I can just go to the BG Fix action and press play. And it will take a minute to think here as it's doing everything, but you can see that it sets everything up exactly how we just did. So that now I don't have to go through and create my new layers or rename anything. I just have everything set up now to where I can just do the rough cleanups on my background, and I can go through and grab my brush tool, and I can paint out what I don't want here on the sides. I can flip over here to the other side of the document, and I can clean that up as well, and just make those seamless transitions happen. Hey guys, so that wraps up this tutorial on how to go through and fix seamless backdrops and remove distractions. Hopefully this helped out a little bit. It's something that we've all dealt with, whether we're working in studio, whether we're working at a small convention booth. Regardless of what that situation is, this is a problem that I've seen and have been asked a lot about. So for me, it's all about perspective and knowing that it's not always about the problem that you're looking at, it's how you're going to hide that problem. You know, so for me, it was just going through and painting over it and throwing a background texture in there that really fixed the issue that I was dealing with so that I could just move right into the more fun parts of the project, which in my case are generally those finishing touches of color grading and really making that image pop. So what we'll do is I'll go over, probably my next tutorial will be on how to make your images pop in Lightroom, where we'll cover and kind of finish up this specific image so that you guys can see some of the tools that I use in Lightroom to really make things stand out and kind of shine the way that I like to. So that's all for now, guys. I will see you in the next video. Make sure to create more, say less, and stay creative. I'll see you next time.